Who's the boy you like the most? Is it teasing you with underage? Could he be waving from a tropical sunset? Static silhouette somehow, single in his bed someday. Quiet till it falls, falls, falls. Roam, 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 roam.
There you go. The blood of Rome was built and first began with the end of the kingdom, with the fall of the final Etruscan king, Lucian, as he was exiled by the noble Brutus. The following clip shows senators discussing the improvement of Roman government with the addition of consuls. The Senate included 300 members and could name a dictator to rule the government for 6 months. This is similar to the U.S. Congress of today. The popular assembly elected 10 officials called tribunes who could veto Senate bills and could declare war. Magistrates were the public officials, including the consuls, the praetors, and the censors. The two consuls ran the government, while the praetors commanded the army and created the laws. The consuls were like the U.S. president, and the praetors like the cabinet. The censors appointed the senators. They were elected every 5 years for a year and a half. The patricians were the upper class of Roman society. They controlled the government and practiced patronage, which is giving jobs to friends. The plebeians were the lower class. They were discriminated against, couldn't hold office, participate in the army, and often got in trouble because they didn't know the laws.
We need a form of government that can be lenient in times of peace, but takes up absolute control in times of war and famine.
This is true. How many shall there be, and what shall we call them?
Two. That way we can establish a more democratic feel on the people.
What shall these two people be called?
Consuls.
All in favor of having consuls?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye!
How will we bring Lucian back to the throne?
We could capture Brutus's son, Thoriacus.
Genius. Already dozens of senators have joined us. Although he will be in the perfect position to cause those councils pain.
Let's capture Thoriacus.
We're gonna go get the Chirus and we're gonna bang him on the head like that.
Okay? I understand.
Let's go.
First, I will throw this money.
Get up!
Oh, he's awake!
At this moment, get up! Stop struggling! Stop struggling!
Okay.
I got his left arm.
I got
his right arm.
My hair is not looking good right now.
Get in the chair. In the chair.
All right, I'm getting.
Your fate is uncertain. Enter the chair.
I've captured Thoriacus.
Your father is weak.
He's not.
Is he? Look around. The blood of the people is spilling all across the land. They cannot control themselves. Lucian ruled with an iron grip. But we have all control. Join us, and you will live in a golden paradise as Lucian's top advisor.
I'm gonna have to agree here.
Good boy.
Good choice. If you didn't agree with
very
us,
good choice.
You would suffer the consequences.
Kill your father.
And lose a phalange.
And die.
The ancient Romans lived on the peninsula of Italy. Its central location provided many opportunities for trade and also war. Unfortunately, the Alps mountain range, unlike many other ancient civilizations, did not provide adequate protection because of the various mountain paths. Armies also invaded by sea. Their lack of natural protection, however, allowed the Romans to excel in combat and warfare. I am feeling cramped. You know, I have only about 100 acres of land. I want more.
Agreed. Okay, so we're right here right now.
We're confined to this little area of Rome.
It's tiny.
Yes.
We need to expand!
Yes, sir.
Yes, we do. Okay, so here's a plan. Okay?
I want my guy, too.
Yeah, you can put you. Yeah, there we go.
Can we come on? There you
go. Wait, hold on. Okay, these are bad guys.
Really?
Yeah. Okay, so here's Rome.
But they're different colors.
We'll send out our armies in this direction and attack the north. And we'll send these armies out and attack the south. And before you know it, we'll have all of Italy.
Hey, that was my piece. And then we'll have and expanded then we'll be victorious. All over here.
Yes.
And we'll have all the territory we need.
Yeah, we got,
Only nobody will.
The next scene shows Roman expansion through the invasions of northern and southern Italy. Adult males who owned the land formed the Roman army. The most important division of the Roman army was the legion. It was formed of 4,500 to 6,000 Roman soldiers. Eventually, the Romans would defeat the Macedonians. The Romans gave partial citizenship to the people of the cities that they conquered. Partial citizens could own property and marry Romans, but they could not vote on Roman laws. Romans giving partial citizenship was known as their loyalty policy.
The southern Italian sun just beautiful.
Indeed.
Soaking up the rays.
Attack the south!
Nice tan. Oh.
Roman armies attack the north!
Work, my brethren.
Yes, you too.
Thanks, man.
Okay, the other one? Dictator, we have defeated the armies of the north and the south. We have been expanded Rome far beyond its previous borders.
Wonderful. Now I can go bask in that Italian sun in the south. I've heard it's excellent.
Can I join you?
Everyone up. All kneel. In respect for our great god Jupiter and his beautiful wife Juno.
Hello, Mr. Priest.
Hello.
I have a confession to make. I've been having some weird thoughts. Something about our religion and gods makes me think along the Greek standards.
Well, I have a confession to make too. We copied the Greeks. We just stole all their gods, and
Oh, well, I see the correlation.
I'm not proud of that, but, I mean, we gave them different names, so just keep it on.
All right, I will. Thank you, Mr. Priest.
You're welcome. May Jupiter be with you.
Jackson Araya, what are you doing with this mindless sack of beans?
Learning how to kick it.
This is false. Bow down in front of me. Your paterfamilias. It was wrong of you to be playing this hacky sack.
Listen, his father! He is absolute authority of the family!
Don't make me use my bow staff, young Jackson Araya.
Don't use your bow staff, father.
He will use what he wants to use on you!
It teaches you courage and respect. Did you hear me?
Courage and respect! Courage and respect!
Good work. Excellent work.
Thank you.
Your father has joined us.
That's phenomenal.
You have achieved what we asked. However, I'm afraid that you are a loose end. And I don't like loose ends.
Yeah, we'll tie you up.
Tie you up.
Wah!
Your fault, although you could have done more. Oh, you're so naive, yeah, so how could this be done with such a smiling sweetheart? Oh, and your sweet and pretty face is such an ugly one for something so beautiful. Oh, that every time I look inside, I know she knows that
I'm not fond of asking. True or false it may be, or she's still out to get me.